me not this cheap crap from Tesco's. And bring me some more strawberries. Oh, Rebel Productions are treating me like I'm some kind of porn star.
Victoria, we're on.
Welcome to Rebel Productions. Evil intentions about to explode on home video. Unquestionably the most violent, sexy and dynamic video in the history of British wrestling. Oh, and by the way, it's Miss V de Montfort to you. Thank you. Well, here I am in Halifax, just a few days after the big event itself, and I can tell you, there's still quite a buzz around the town. I mean, Halifax hasn't been so busy since the last rugby team won a match, and that was some time ago. Well, here it is to own on home video, the hottest show of the year, Evil Intentions, hosted by the hottest woman, me, Victoria de Montfort. On Saturday, August the 5th, 2000, Halifax was really hot, but inside the Northbridge Leisure Centre, it was even hotter. Now this is more like it. As you can see, the crowd were well up for the opening match, which was a contract on a pole match. The contenders, the establishment, were Mark Sloan, Gary Hayward, and Paul Travell. The rules for the match were simple. To gain the number one contendership contract on a pole, or by pinning one man's shoulder to the mat. And look out for a very special surprise.
Thank you. I just cannot wait until the Brown Panties on a pole match tonight. I mean, it's the first time this has been done in British wrestling history. Wouldn't you say?
Tony, I'm not wearing any brown panties. Well, you know I never wear any brown panties when I've got an event. It just gives my fans so much more excitement.
Well, thank you very much, Victoria. Once again, you screw it all up. Now I'm going to have to go to Ann Summers myself and get you some brown panties. Thank you very much.
Oh, nobody speaks to me like that. I'm going to find myself a real man. Hi, big boy. I'm waiting for you in my dressing room. That's so good. Yeah, I can't wait till next time. You were so active. Oh, look, I've got to go. I think Johnny's at the door to apologise again. Bye. Yes.
Hi, princess, it's me. I've just got the brown panties.
Oh, Johnny! They're so small. Oh, they must be so revealing.
They are, they're more or less made out of cotton. You can barely see everything.
Oh, wicked. That's so good. Oh, thank you.
It's okay, little princess. You know, just... Wait a minute, what's this white stuff on your mouth?
Toothpaste?
Of course, yeah. Anyway, I have to go and get ready, so I'll speak to you later.
Okay.
And wear those especially for me.
Oh, I will. See you later. They're so small.
I know. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah!
Gary Haywood won my managerial services. And, quite a lot more. The match continued versus Paul Travell and Mark Sloan for the contract. From earlier. And the less said about that, the better. Harry Haywood should realise just what he's missing out on. So, Paul Travell won that one, and is now the number one contender for the FWA title. That very championship belt was declared vacant at a recent FWA event, and thus, a tournament was set up for evil intentions. The format of the tournament is simple. There were four first round matches, and the winner of each advanced into the fatal four-way final on the same evening. Here are the highlights of each first round match, with the winner advancing to the finals. Ugh. This isn't strong enough! I want Stellar or something! Bring me...
Two! here at Evil Intentions tonight in Halifax. I've just had a look through into the locker room where all the wrestlers are getting ready. Let me tell you, passions are running high for every single one of tonight's matchups. What we're going to try and do is grab one or two of the participants as they come through and get their thoughts on their matches coming up later on tonight. One thing is for certain, Evil Intentions is set to be one unforgettable evening. Shut up!
Set of matches in the tournament, which makes me feel rather hot. That now leaves the fatal four-way match for the FWA Championship, putting Guy Thunder, Justin Richards and Scotty Rock and George Costana battling it out later on this video in what is sure to be a wild confrontation. Now we go back to ringside for a very special routine by one of the most controversial factions in British wrestling history. Led by Spirit of Instinct, it's Dead Souls performing Loyal to the Darkness.
Thank you.
Now that was a fantastic routine. All members of the Dead Souls and the Alchemist came to the ring for an interview. However, it turned out to be more than just that. To begin with, Spirit of Instinct informed the Alchemist faction that consisted of the British tag team champions, the New Breed, along with Enigma, that if they wanted to become members of Dead Souls, then they would have to prove themselves, setting up a triple threat match later in the evening. This didn't go down too well with Enigma, as he didn't want to fight his teammates, but the match was on anyway. After the Alchemist had left the ring, the Extreme World Warfare champion, the Dominator, made his way to the ring and began to insult his challenger, Frankie Capone. This brought out Capone and his friend the Flatliner for an unexpected confrontation. Emotions were running high all night long, and the EWW Championship match later in the evening should be no exception. Speaking of emotions, my good friend John Felton wasn't pleased with the flatliner, Chris Manns, or his skank of a girlfriend, Tanya, either. After the flatliner viciously attacked him at FWA, Sometimes They Come Back, last October. This was his night for revenge, as he put up £1,000 on the line for any man or woman to defeat the flatliner. John also offered me some protection from Gary Hayward, who is definitely sexually frustrated. So, here's exactly what happened in the special gauntlet match.
Ah! Thank you. After tomorrow night's match, that I think that Pat Patterson will probably make the opportunity for him to move up within the organization right there.
Thank you very much. Thing is, we don't have to wait till tomorrow if you want. Then we can start right here if you want to.
Michael, as much as I'd like to oblige you, as far as I know, this is a sold-out event this tomorrow night, and unless we got enough videotape so we can simply show the replay of what may happen, I know being that your ECW legacy right there, we only have one table here right now, and I didn't have to use up a couple tables on you, pretty much all the chairs, but I will grant you that opportunity. I will keep my calm exterior here right now. But come tomorrow night, you may see recollections of Tarzan go to the right there.
TNA? Holy shit.
She knows. Oh, hold it! Hold that. Vicky, come back.
This is for the Evil Intention documentary.
Yes.
How are you enjoying your stay in the UK?
Oh, it's great. It's beautiful, yeah, and we're really honored to be here.
Yeah, it's been a good weekend so far.
Sure has.
Yeah, good night last night.
As a matter of fact, I stayed in so I could be on my best behavior today.
Right. So you're going to be a good girl today?
Maybe for a little while, anyway.
Maybe someone provokes you, maybe.
Oh, well, you know what? These hands are lethal weapons, so I have to watch myself.
What do your trainees have to expect from you this afternoon?
Well, we better be prepared to work hard because we're going to work them really hard. And we're looking forward to working with the people that are interested in learning the pro style and kind of a little bit of shoot style here in the UK. So we're pretty excited.
This is far the biggest show I've worked yet. Last year I worked Scorched Earth, and that was pretty big. And this one is probably triple that.
So. Do you prefer working in the US or?
It's not. It's a totally different ball game over here. It's not really. I actually make more money when I come over here than I do in the States. Because when you import talent, things like that, you make a lot more money. But the fans are a lot better here than they are in the States. Yeah. As far as the Dominator is concerned, He drank a little bit more than I did, so he's laying up in the bed about 2 miles down the road. So I don't think he's going to be ready to kick mine.
And he's just got out of bed. Disgrace.
Hi, John. You haven't spoken to the people today.
Haven't I?
No.
I wonder why. Very busy, but it's going all right. Everything we've done so far has been a success, but the big one still comes, so it's like, it's giving you a bit more confidence, but not.
Yeah, yeah.
It's still stuff can still go wrong, but I'm a bit more optimistic than I was. So.
Yeah. You think this is really
well? Yeah, every single thing done has been packed out with fans. Been really pleased. Just got to go and say thanks to Finn and...
Das Ganze mal ausschauen. Hier sind sie Becky, Levi und Titantron. Very spectacular looking. And look at that shit. And here's waving guy, Victoria, the Red Rooster and Kidman, die UK-Version von Billy the Kid Kidman. Also with the Red Rooster in it. So to the fans, please know the very fact. Upload this shit.
And tiring weekend for myself with the VIP party and the fan convention. I mean, people were just mobbing me for my autograph, and I mean, some pervert even offered me £100 for a quickie behind the bush. How disgusting! As if he could ever get Victoria de Montfort for £100. Mind you, came in handy for my nice new leather coat here. Anyway, back to Evil Intentions. Biggest night in history of British wrestling. The next match is one that was set up earlier in the night by the Spirit of Instinct, waiting to prove themselves to Dead Souls. This is Curve, Ash, and Enigma of the Alchemists, battling each other, with the referee being none other than Spirit of Instinct himself. You know, I was told that all these men wanted to sleep with me. Well, who would blame them? Come on, I am Victoria de Montfort.
Cut, please.
What the hell's going on? Who the hell do you think you are cutting in the middle of my speech when I was just about to tell you who the hell I am? Who the hell do you think you are? I mean, for God's sake, I'm sat here, Victoria de Montfort.
Thank you.
Those three men work damn hard. And I can tell you boys, if you ever need a reward, then just come and see me any time. The next match, FWA Evil Intentions, has a long history. And if you have one of these programs here, you can read all about the history of the EWW title match. You guessed it. Next up is Frankie Capone taking on the Dominator from Dead Souls. This match is sure to be extreme.
Thank you.
I told you things at Evil Intentions were hotting up. So much so that I need to cool off a bit. Oh, just in time for one of our three main events. The FWA title is vacant and will be decided in the fatal four-way match featuring Scotty Rock, George Castano, Justin Richards, and Guy Thunder. By the looks of things, after this one, I may need to strip some more.
Thank you.
So Justin Richards is the new FWA champion. Now that's what I call a real man. And if he should need any advice on his newfound fame, then who else to come to but me? I sure know how to deal with fans. What could follow such a high-impact match? What else? Dan, the Beast 7, taking on Michael Kovac from Germany. Now, this match is no holds barred, which means there is no disqualification and no count-out. The only way to win this match is by pinfall or submission. With Kovac's amazing talent and Seven's UFC background, this should be a classic. Now, we're crossing to James Marston, who is backstage with Michael Kovac.
Now just ahead of his match this evening with Dan the Beast 7. And when it comes down to it, Michael, Dan 7, former Ultimate Fighting Champion, former NWA World Heavyweight Champion. On paper, you're the major underdog here.
Hey, stop right here. I'm the major underdog? Oh, maybe you're right. But that's not a bad thing, because if I'm the underdog, there's no psychological pressure on me. You know, Dan's the Ultimate Fighting Champion. Dan has been the NWA Champion, but I'm the German Champion. His success was long years ago, back to the 80s or someone. Something like that, or 70s, I don't know when they had these big sideburns. But I'm here, I'm now, I'm the future. I'm the future of the European wrestling scene. I've got it all. I've got the looks, I've got the body, I've got the brains. And to top it off, I've got something very big in my pants, okay? So, I don't mind if I'm the underdog, because it takes all the pressure off me. I can go into the match relaxed, and you know, the plan is, I don't have a plan. I just go in there, beat this old guy, walk out victorious, which makes me the next champion of the people of England, of Germany, of Europe, of the world, okay?
Bye, Dan the B7. Dan, back in a professional wrestling ring here tonight in Halifax in the UK. Tell me, how does this compare with the challenges you've faced so far in your illustrious career?
James, yes, tonight I'm here in a professional wrestling match. I'll be stepping into the square circle. But whether I step inside of a square circle or if I step inside of a steel octagon, it doesn't matter. When I step out there, he won't be facing just Dan Severn. He will be facing the Beast this evening. There's only one man in this world that has 11 total world title belts around their waist, and you're looking at him right here. When I step in there against Michael this evening, he will be facing the Beast, and there's only one man in the world that can claim that title. And Michael, I hope you have your insurance policy paid up right now, because it's going to be null and destroyed.
All right, Dan Severn against Michael Kovac's next.
Come on, hold! Thank you. Thank you. this?
Go back!
What a fantastic match that you can only find right here to own on Rebel Productions' own home video, FWA, Evil Intentions. Now, I know that you all came to see one thing and one thing only, and that's to see me get naked. Oh, and to see Evil Intentions. Now, there's one hardcore match left to see. Two titles are on the line in this match. The Dirt Bike Kid puts his EWA Junior Heavyweight title on the line, and the homicidal, suicidal, genocidal, hardcore legend Sabu puts his XBW World Heavyweight title up for grabs. This one is not for the weak of heart.
Thank you.
mentions on home video to own forever. And just think, boys, every time you get those little urges, I'm there on the screen for you to rewind and rewind and rewind just until you please yourselves.
Thank you. Yeah. not knowing.
Quite frankly, what we've come up with is, since you are able to regurgitate, you know, on command, it just seems to me that it's pretty logical that you should be puke.
It's all supposed to be fun.
The Rock is the most electrifying man in sports entertainment today.
It's not supposed to be real.
You're not going to be scared, right?
It's going to be okay.
You can go on Back to the Future. You can do anything. Right?
Again.
But behind the scenes, it's a whole different story.
Everyone feels like they got their money's worth out there.
And for the first time ever, you'll know the real truth.
He's got a puke! He's got a puke! He's got a puke!
It is showtime!
The hard facts.
Really worried about him as far as his health.
You need a new knee now.
She's going to live here the rest of her life, probably, and have seven kids and seven husbands, and she'll always remember tonight, man.
The family pain.
You make it sound like you don't even want to live.
There's times I know. There's a lot of times I know.
The real danger.
Shut up!
I'm a very violent person, and I'll hurt you. So I get paid to do what I'm doing. That's like with any entertainer.
Come face to face with the wrestling world the way it's never been seen before.
Gave up Wall Street for?
Wall Street wasn't fun. Wrestling is fun.
It's still hard after all these years.
We did it! I just don't want to hurt no more.
This is the dance!
Beyond the mat.
I think we touched a lot of people, if you don't mind me saying.